สวัสดีครับ and good day to you wherever you are in the world. Thank you for tuning into my YouTube channel. David Found is here with you today and I wanted to talk to you and perhaps help you avoid something that may happen to you, whether it's happening now or could it well happen in the near future, is a problem with your Alpha series cameras. I have an Alpha or A7R3. This is my camera and I've just returned from the Sony repair center here in Bangkok at Phetchaburi, the Sony repair center. And the reason for that is that I about three, maybe 2 weeks ago, I was doing a job and all of a sudden there is no image showing in the viewfinder, which was alarming, but it's not that it hasn't happened before. It has happened before, but I sort of got an idea of what the problem was, and I did a bit of a cleanup on the few of the external components here, and it solved the problem, or it fixed it temporarily, should I say. So the issue is more serious now, is that 4 or 5 months ago, when I experienced the first issue of the viewfinder blackout, essentially the sensor was not switching, the proximity sensor was not switching between LCD screen and the viewfinder, which I find annoying because I use the viewfinder an awful lot, because I like sort of precision focusing, more accurate focusing in a lot of cases. And also when you're in sort of bright surroundings, it's not always convenient to use the LCD screen. So so a few months ago had the problem of the sensor wasn't detecting my proximity, closeness to the camera. I could put my fingers there, I put my face there, and it wasn't switching from LCD screen to the viewfinder. The LCD screen stayed on all the time, even though it's set to automatic. And I know a lot of people get annoyed, get frustrated by that auto switching, which can be frustrating sometimes, because you can be, perhaps you're on a gimbal and there's the back plate, and there can be, when there's some movement there, the viewfinder can switch out, the LCD can switch off, and it can revert to the viewfinder. I don't think that's a big issue. I think it's just very easy to overcome. You can turn off the auto sensor, auto switching. I just leave it on auto. I think it's absolutely fine. But anyway, couple of weeks ago, I was out in a very hot environment. The climate was quite hot. I'm in Bangkok, as you probably know or not know, but I'm in Bangkok in Thailand. So temperatures have been quite cool actually recently, compared to earlier later in 2020. But now it's January 2021, and a couple of weeks ago, I was on a job. Predominantly shooting about 45 degrees, and all of a sudden the viewfinder just went black, just blacked out on me. Nothing in the viewfinder whatsoever. So I thought, well, maybe it's the same problem that I had previously, whereby at 45 degrees, at 90 degrees, 45 degrees, most cases, is that I'm close to the camera, and of course, in this hot climate, and me being a sweater, I perspire quite profoundly in many cases. And so essentially what's been happening over a period of time is that my perspiration, my sweat, my salty sodium embroiled sweat has been dripping into the viewfinder, and this of course has got full of electronics as well, and the viewfinder's dead, it's died completely. So hopefully This video today will help you avoid a potential problem you may face with your A7 or Alpha series cameras, or any other cameras essentially that have any electronics or electronic viewfinders, EVFs, electronic viewfinders, whereby there are sensors and there are electronics, computer chips essentially in here with a sensor. And if you're a sweater like I am and you're dripping sweat, salty sweat, onto these components, onto these electronics, the chances are that at some stage it's going to cause a problem with the electronics. Now, as you may or may not be able to see, the screw heads, in fact, this is a telltale sign of a problem. In fact, this is good advice that at periodically, this is the viewfinder rubber cup, that obviously sits on there. Over a period of time, this has become quite brittle and there's been little pieces have been breaking off, which is something that should warn you of potential problems with your camera. So just to continue with, we were talking about telltale signs of potential problems with your A7 camera. So what do we need to look for? We looked at the screw heads here, which show very clearly that there's corrosion, meaning there's more depth to this issue than is on the surface of just that corrosion of the screw heads. So there's obviously something else going on inside, and that's happened to my camera. One other area that you should also look at is particularly this cover here, which covers the flash sync connection and the microphone. If you take this down as far as it will go, basically to there, you'll see there's another screw head here, and that is one that's been showing corrosion as well. So Sony, you need to help us fix these problems, and maybe do it for free, because this is a problem that Sony has not considered to be a potential issue over a period of a couple of years. Now, a camera that's only two and a half years old is not an old camera. If it's 5, 6 and more, I would say that, yeah, there's probably going to be some problems, but this is still a young camera, relatively speaking. So these are things that you should be looking for to save yourself problems with your camera in the future. And of course, these take off the rubber cap. Don't just leave that on, because obviously that is trapping. This traps perspiration, it traps sweat. So take that off periodically and have a look at whether or not there's corrosion on the screw heads. This camera has quite a lot of corrosion on the screw heads, because I haven't been looking at that. I didn't ever consider that to be a potential problem with my camera, but I have now, and now I've got my camera out of the Sony service center because I need my camera back whilst they are waiting for parts, which obviously doesn't make any sense for my camera to be sat on a shelf at the Sony repair center, whereby I won't be able to use it and they can't do anything with it for at least a couple of weeks whilst the parts are being delivered from Singapore to Bangkok. So this is something that I hope that you can avoid with your Sony camera, A7 III, A7, whatever it is, because they all have this sensor and electronics. It's electronic viewfinder, after all, EVF. You're not looking through the lens directly on the mirror. It's a mirrorless camera. So this means that the camera has to increase the amount of electronics providing you with an image. So beware of these potential hazards, potential problems, and hopefully you will save yourself some problems because of this video. I hope you can. Also, I'm not sure if I showed you this before, but you may or may not see here that there's actually paint has been stripped off. Paint has been peeling off the LCD screen's mount, metal or mild steel mount here, and paint has been stripping off there. It's actually been peeling off, which is another telltale sign that the camera has sustained some corrosion, and the corrosion is not because of moisture. I don't think it's because of rain, because I've not actually, it's not actually been subjected to any rainfall, but it's all to do with me, my sweat. So hopefully my video is helping you solve yourself a problem. Tune in, subscribe if you already haven't. Thank you for those subscribers I already have. Hopefully you can help me get to 1,000, and maybe I can monetize my station, my channel at some stage in the near future. I'm going to start providing you with a few more tutorials, a bit more advice on camera equipment. I'm a professional photographer, cameraman. I've taught in university, and hopefully we can be of help to you too. Thank you for joining me today from Bangkok. It's David Found, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.